yet there were occasional wafts of something sweeter, for there was a mass of colourful flora both on the balconies and in the hills behind. Dropping his gaze, Barclay cast an eye over the crew of his barge. Being wealthy, he had outfitted them in a manner he thought appropriate to his dignity. Every oarsman had a hat with a bright red ribbon, a short blue jacket with brass buttons, this over a cambric shirt. All wore matching bright red bandanas, clean white ducks, and by their feet as they worked the sticks, a pair of patent leather shoes to be put on as they accompanied him ashore. There were two marines along, and they would guard the barge while it was tied up. The saluting had taken place at first light, HMS Semele acknowledging the royal standard and the locals replying to his own flags, not least that of Vice-Admiral Hottam. His departure from the ship had been noted, so there were dignitaries on the quay waiting to welcome him, which they did as soon as Devineux, leaping onto the solid surface first, reached down a hand to aid Barclay up the short ladder.
"Be quick about your business, Gerson," were the last words the captain said as he ascended.
The clerk ignored an injunction made too many times already. He had a decent purse in his coat pocket, and that he patted to reassure himself, which occasioned a discreet smile, for he reckoned not to disperse it but to keep the contents. Gerson hoped Ralph Barclay had shown his naivety when he had handed it over. What good would it do to seek an interpreter and question Italians regarding Emily Barclay? If she was in Naples, the people who would be aware of her presence would be English, and there had to be a rate of his countrymen in such a busy trading port. It was also common knowledge that many a rich traveller from home landed up here, usually in search of antiquities from Pompeii and Herculaneum, with which to return home and decorate their mansions and country piles. Having been an avid reader of popular journals in London, wishing himself to be rich, he was eager to hear of the exploits of those he intended to emulate, Gerson knew of Ambassador Hamilton.